Hello, I'm Ty Mason of the diabeteskouncil.com, researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. Today I want to talk about what you need to know concerning alcohol and diabetes. After you watch the video today, I invite you to check out the description box for my new ebook. This is one of the most comprehensive diabetes meal planning books you can find anywhere. It contains diabetes-friendly meals and recipes. Also recipes for different goals, such as 800 to 1800 calories per day meal plans, diabetes meal planning tips and tricks, and there are also tons of diabetes-friendly recipes for everyone. There is a misconception that those with diabetes should not consume any alcohol, but the American Diabetes Association actually approves of those with diabetes having a drink or two. However, alcohol is not a typical carb, and understanding its relationship to blood sugar levels and diabetes is paramount to using it responsibly. Many people with type 2 diabetes think they need to eliminate alcohol completely from their diet, but in moderation, alcohol may actually have some health benefits. For instance, moderate alcohol consumption may reduce the risk of developing diabetes in people who don't have the condition, particularly women. That's according to data analysis published in the September 2015 issue of Diabetes Care. And in people who have type 2 diabetes that is well controlled, a glass of red wine a day as part of a healthy diet may actually help improve heart disease risk factors, according to results of a two-year study published in the Annals of Internal Medicine in October of 2015. However, you need to be thoughtful about including any type of alcohol, even red wine, in your type 2 diabetes management plan. According to Liz Brulard, who is a nutrition manager at the Boston Medical Center's Center for Endocrinology, Nutrition, and Weight Management in Massachusetts, the most important thing is to make sure you aren't drinking alcohol on an empty stomach. Now, she recommends only drinking alcohol with a meal or a snack that contains both carbs and protein. That's because alcohol can actually lower your blood sugar, creating a risky situation for people with type 2. I think this might be a good time to talk about the liver. Why? Well, the liver has this special ability. It's called gluconeogenesis, and this is a process where the liver releases glucose from its glycogen store. The liver gets the glucose by two different ways. One is the excess glucose from a meal or a snack, and it will be stored in a reservoir in the liver in the form of glucogen. The liver can also make glucose from fat and proteins. This storage of glucose is useful in the event of a low blood sugar event. When the body senses a low blood sugar, it sends a signal to the liver to release glucose to slow down or prevent a severe reaction. Now, as many of you know, alcohol affects the liver. Well, how? Well, one way it does is to inhibit the liver to release glucose. A few minutes after you consume an alcoholic beverage, the alcohol finds its way into the bloodstream. About an hour and a half later, the blood alcohol is at its highest level. The stomach cannot break down the alcohol. The body recognizes the alcohol is toxic, and so the liver works very hard to break it down and get rid of it. This can take a long time. It can actually take up to 8 hours or more. Now, since the liver is working so hard to get rid of the alcohol, it shuts off everything else, including the release of glucose into the body. Therefore, this increases the risk of a severe low blood sugar episode. This also means that you may not have low blood sugar until 8 hours after the drinks. This could lead to a very serious case of hypoglycemia and honestly can be deadly. And the symptoms of hypoglycemia, sleepiness, dizziness, disorientation, can often look like being intoxicated. So if signs of hypoglycemia are mistaken for drunkenness, well, you may not get the help and treatment you need. Now, as stated earlier, the American Diabetes Association says that those with diabetes can drink, but they also qualify that to say no more than one drink per day for women and no more than two drinks per day for men. Now, an example of one alcoholic drink is a 5-ounce glass of wine, a 1.5-ounce shot of liquor, or a 12-ounce beer. Now, more than that can lead to different levels of intoxication and not good for one with diabetes on many levels. As already stated, it can cause a severe condition of hypoglycemia. It also means you can't think as clearly. You need to be able to take the correct dosage of insulin and other medications. You need to test your blood sugar and be aware of how you are overall feeling. You don't want to be intoxicated and take the wrong dose of meds or none at all, and then have more problems on your hands to deal with. Now, one very important factor when choosing to drink, and we've mentioned this before, but it is very important, do so with a meal. This will help to somewhat absorb the alcohol. Mainly, this will help you in regards to hypoglycemia. If you aren't drinking with a meal, at least have some high-carb snacks available. I think that might be the reason pretzels are so popular at bars. Now, in addition to watching and counting your serving size, here's some tips for safer drinking. Wear a MediAlert bracelet or a necklace. Identify yourself as one with diabetes. Talk to your doctor first. Confirm that drinking alcohol is safe for you and ask what blood sugar levels to look for and how to balance food. Monitor your blood sugar before as well as after drinking. The American Diabetes Association advises not drinking alcohol if your blood sugar is out of control. Be aware of supersized drinks. Though beer is usually served in a standard size glass, wine and liquor, well, they get a more generous pour. Some craft beers can have a higher concentration of alcohol as well, so you would need to drink less than the typical 12-ounce serving. Account for alcohol properly. Alcohol does not replace food in your meal plan. However, do count any snacks you have with your drink along with mixers such as soda or juice. And if you are going to have mixers, choose sugar-free ones, diet soda, or seltzer when making alcoholic drinks yourself. And drink plenty of water. Don't rely on alcoholic beverages to quench your thirst. Drink a glass of water along with or after each drink. Most definitely have a designated driver. We don't want you drinking and driving. And test your blood sugar before bed. Alcohol can have a delayed effect on your blood sugar, and you want to avoid going to bed with low levels. Blood sugar should be between 100 and 140 at bedtime. You can still enjoy a drink when you have type 2, and a glass of red wine might even be good for you. Just plan ahead so that the alcohol fits safely into your diabetes management plan. I hope this has answered your questions about alcohol and diabetes. Don't forget to get my new ebook, like this video, and subscribe to our channel so we can continue to bring you informative videos like this one in the future. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Ty Mason.